Weather corroborating is something we're going to have to talk to Nick about.
This next one's going to occur in April, and that can be difficult to get clear skies compared to the last one when we had back in August of 2017. We're dealing with some clouds, in fact, this morning as well. Most of us waking up with dry weather, though there's no rain falling out of the sky, there is still a lot of dampness. There's a heavy dew on the grass because of all the rain that we had around here yesterday. Temperatures in most areas dropping back into the upper 60s and lower 70s overnight. We do have a light breeze this morning from the south and southwest. A few spotty showers this afternoon, primarily in some of our southern counties. The chance of rain today is much lower than yesterday. It's likely not worth canceling any plans over today, and most of these, again, likely into western Kentucky. Once the rain gets out of here, as we head into Wednesday and Thursday, the heat, it's going to feel like July as we start to see temperatures return quickly back into the 90s. And if you need to get some yard work done, you may want to get it done here on Wednesday and Thursday, because by the end of the week, we do expect some more wet weather in our forecast. This morning, we've been tracking just a couple showers already starting to show up, mainly back into parts of western Kentucky. These are over near Katy's, Kentucky, and continue to move away from us, but we will likely see a few more develop later on this afternoon. Big area of low pressure has been really stubborn, a slow-moving storm system, and today we're going to get back on the backside of that, and that's why our rain chances will be just a little lower this afternoon. Clouds will help keep temperatures down, and again, our best rain chances will be in some of our southern counties, mainly into western Kentucky. And even there, the chance of overall seeing a shower is pretty low. Tomorrow morning, waking up upper 60s. And then tomorrow afternoon, some sunshine returns. But as that sunshine returns on Wednesday afternoon, here you go. High temperatures right back into the upper 80s and lower 90s. So our rain chances going down Wednesday and Thursday. The heat turning up, though. 90 on Wednesday, 91 on Thursday. And then our rain chances ramping back up by the end of this week. That will help keep temperatures down just a bit. This is Friday and into Saturday. A front makes its way in from the north and stalls, likely very close to our region, and that is going to lead to some more chances for wet weather. It's really something to pay attention to. Maybe if you've got some plans coming up this weekend, especially Friday and Saturday, track any showers and storms that do pop up this afternoon with that Storm Track 3 app. You'll notice here with the rain chances, only about a 20% chance today, and I've taken it out of the forecast for Wednesday and Thursday. But again, as the rain moves out, the heat turns up. Now by Friday, up to a 60% chance for some showers and storms that sticks around through much of this weekend, and the rain chances at least keep temperatures down just a bit. But looks like more wet weather through the end of the weekend, first part of next week, before some more dry weather finally returns by next Wednesday and Thursday. But yesterday, gosh, some of those showers and storms were just putting down some really, really heavy rainfall. We had some localized flash flooding. I don't expect that today, and a lot of folks are just now ready to dry out. But with all the moisture around, even when the rain stopped yesterday, the sunshine came out, you could feel the humidity, and it's going to be here through the rest of this week.
I had to clean my gutters again yesterday, and, and I was like, man, I mean, it was...
Well, it had been a while since we have seen that much rain.
Yeah, well, I appreciate that, Nick.
I'm okay to not have.